Hello and welcome to another video. I'm Dr. Sil, and in this video, we're going to be looking at a video of someone with bipolar affective disorder and that they're currently in a manic episode. Now, a bit of background around what bipolar is. Normally, you and I have variability in mood, okay? Sometimes we're happy, sometimes we're sad. But if you have bipolar affective disorder, that variability is much more exaggerated, especially type 1. That when they go up, we call that mania, and when they go down in mood, we call that depression. But if you have both, we call that bipolar disorder. Now, it's worth noting that if someone has bipolar disorder, most of the illness is actually spent, unfortunately, in a depressive episode with infrequent bouts in mania. Another thing I'd like to address is the fact that a lot of people think that mania is like really good, high energy, super productive. Everyone wishes they could sleep less and do more things. Mania is not like that. Mania is quite awful. Although they might sleep less and have more energy, it's usually misdirected energy and associated with behaviors that they wouldn't normally do. Let's have a look at this video. Maybe we'll see some of the characteristics of mania. I think we will. And we're going to be going on to Pika Grape Snack. This is a great YouTube channel and 350,000 subscribers and heaps of old school videos from the 60s and 50s about different mental illnesses or different scientific things. Some are a bit strange. And the one we're watching today is Mania in Bipolar Disorder Psychiatric Interview from the 1980s. So this one's from the 80s. Let's begin.
Rich, I wonder if you can tell me something about what was happening just before you came to the hospital.
Well, what started it was I was just watching the night news program, trying to maintain and cope when my mother came in and just started yelling and screaming at me. So I just yelled and screamed back, and she said I was crazy, and so I just called the mental health center about five times one night, and then I got $25 from my brother, drove about 80 miles on it, got my watch fixed, went to a couple of health food stores and had a drink, all this is in Martinsville, and rode my bicycle 20 miles and went to the drugstore six times, and just did one thing at a time. You know, I was just trying to get my life back together, but I guess I was doing it too fast for some people, but I know exactly what I do. I know when I make right and left hand turns, and I can count to 10. When I get to 11, it's 2, because we cross out zeros in base 10 in the Arabic system, and well, I guess it's the basis of numerology or something. But when I get fast, the world gets slow. And when I get slow, the world gets fast. And when I'm in the middle, everything seems to be going okay.
This is a pretty classical presentation of pressured speech. It wasn't that quick in terms of rate, but I can imagine that would have been difficult to interrupt. Also, a bit of flight of ideas. Like, I found that pretty hard to follow, and it just kind of felt a bit tangential. A couple things to note. Standing up, taking your jackets off, very typical. I'm actually questioning if this guy is acting, and this is like an educational thing, because of it's just very stereotypical, and humans don't usually read the textbooks when they have mental illnesses. Taking off the jumpers, throwing them on the floor, that's very overfamiliar. The flight of ideas is pretty typical of a manic episode, and I kind of liked what he said that when the world gets fast, I get slow. So that's okay when he's in a depressive, so that suggests that he's had like history of depression, which we would have to characterize further. When he gets fast, the world gets slow, so he's too quick, and often that can be associated with irritability with people. Irritability can lead to violence and that kind of thing, so you have to always do risk assessments with people who are in manic episodes.
And I'm stable. It's kind of like the princess and the pea, you know. I'm just a really sensitive person. I had this white German Shepherd one time. I got him from my eighth grade civics teacher.
And throw it on the floor?
I was talking to my older brother on the phone the other day, and he said, "Well, Rich, how you doing?" And I said, "Well, you know, I've got something wrong with my liver. I might have hepatitis, but that's the fucking break." So, you know, there was a movie, Missouri Breaks.
Okay, two things there. First, he might have hepatitis, so we want to do risk assessments into, is he having unprotected sex? Is he using IV drugs? Is this out of character for him? There's a kind of saying in mental health that manic episode ends in one of three ways: in jail, in the hospital, or dead, because those are the three kind of outcomes from mania. Obviously, it can self-resolve sometimes. Often, people do impulsive things that result in them ending in one of those three ways, which is a bit scary. Now, for him to have hepatitis means that we have to do a lot of medical testing on him. And that's a good reminder for anyone watching that if you want to become a mental health doctor, the first thing you are is a physician, and then the second thing you are is a mental health doctor. So first you always have to do organic screens, do blood tests. The fact that he's taking off jumpers means that a differential here could be hyperthyroidism. So we want to do thyroid levels on him. Thyroid is the hormone, it's a gland in your neck that produces hormones that makes you metabolically active. So if you have high thyroid levels, you can feel really jittery, really hot. You got to think about the physical health and the mental health. Let's keep going.
I don't know why everybody calls me Hollywood, but one time we were doing art therapy and this lady told me that I wasn't doing the art assignment right. And I do art my own way, and mine was one of the best in the class.
So that's grandiosity, thinking, he's quite incredible.
I got so mad. I just took out the scissors and cut it off recently. I just don't know.
Impulsivity?
But I got around to see my mother and my ex-girlfriend, Annie Oakley, existential Marie Stokely. Saw her over Christmas at Poplar Bluff, and boy, did it rain. You'll see no other lady finer than her, really. Really. Oh gosh, I'm just getting carried away. This is so hot. Here, let me take off my shoes. My nice Dexter shoes. You know, Dexter, Missouri is on Courage Rib down
okay,
by
so
Poplar Bluff.
Overfamiliar, taking shoes off during an interview with a psychiatrist.
Over,
and
the Mississippi floodplain, but I'm from Oz, or the Ozarks, and our people down there, lo and behold, are the Raiders. Did you see that movie, Raiders of the Lost Ark?
Flight of ideas, jumping, tangential.
I almost felt that. You know, there are three people on this board from Missouri. There's two from St. Louis and one from Poplar Bluff, and PB is the atomic symbol for...
We are 3.5 minutes in, and the interviewer, or I think is a psychiatrist, has not been able to ask a single question. That tells you something about the spontaneity of the speech.
Lead on the elemental chart, and our water has this rust-colored water in it, and lead is some kind of thing for, these dense elements. But I got this at the OH, the Opportunity House. We went down there in group, and this lady came out with a shirt and said, would you like this? This is something you might like for 50 cents. And, well, I'll take it off now.
Okay.
Oh, this is fun. Well, here's what
on
we
the
wear
floor?
In the hospital.
On the floor?
My surgeon's gown. Ta-da!
Wow.
It's so nice and yellow. It reminds me of Baba Ram Dass, or those Dal people, Hare, hare, om, om, om. Om backwards is the abbreviation for Missouri. And the Omni, this bar in town, is O-M-N-I, and backwards I-N. And when I came to St.
So this guy is also very distractible. He's showing a lot of signs of mania. So things like high energy. Let's just keep going.
When I came to Indiana in 76, they dropped the D off the I-N. So Omni backwards is I-N-M-O, in Mo, the two states of the universe. Oh, do you believe me? Oh, I wish I had my A to Z astrological delineator and encyclopedia, because since I've been in Indiana, I've done 300 or 400 natal birth charts for people. I remember one of my favorite classes at IU was Chinese and Japanese appreciation. This little lady, Kathy, and I taught them how to do lotus positions, and we studied Zen with meditation. And I was always looking at this yellow. Well, let me take some of these clothes off my pants here.
Do you have something on under them?
Well, let's see. Whoops! Oh, it's my surgeon's pants! Ta-da! Oh, let me get these off now. Be here now. Remember, be here now. Oh, I've got even more on under these. Let me show you my street clothes for the day.
This guy's like a Russian doll.
I don't know. But
a Russian doll that just keeps going in and out of another one. There's a lot of signs of mania in this here. High energy, obviously, distractibility, flight of ideas, pressured speech. He shows themes of grandiosity, delusional content hasn't been deeply explored, but I could imagine. The thing with mania is that it can become psychosis, just like with depression. Depression can become depression with psychosis if it's really extreme. And when mania is very extreme, you can get delusions and it can essentially become a psychotic mania. I think with him, we have to do a bit more of a risk assessment to screen for risk of harm to others or self or risk of misadventure. Find out a bit about why he has hepatitis, see if he would, if he's been using drugs or spending money or being sexually disinhibited, and that would also carry risks with other people as well. That's a little bit of a rundown on mania. A pretty interesting case, a lot more to talk about with him. There's many more questions to ask, as well as all the organic stuff that we would have to do to rule out any organic pathology. Very interesting case, and if you guys have any comments or things you picked up on, write down in the comments below. I've done another reaction video to catatonic schizophrenia, which is really fun to do. If you enjoy these videos, please let me know and I'll make more of them. And until next time, I hope you all have an absolutely lovely day. If you want to support the channel, please consider subscribing or leaving the video a like. That really helps the channel grow. Have a lovely day, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.